chariot, the Marvel to the heavens. So he is the chariot now himself. Marvel to the, he is carrying now while he is coming down in the chariot, he is carrying the marvels of heavens, all the riches of heaven, the plenitudes of heaven, the beatitudes of heaven. He is carrying now with him a chariot to the marvels of the heaven, broad base to bear the gods on fiery wheel. So that is a kind of a chariot. Whom he is bringing in the chariot? What are the marvels? Apart from the marvels, the possibility, the potentiality, the greatnesses of the spirit, he is also bringing in the chariot the gods, the powers of light. Gods are the powers of light, the guardians of light, the promoters of light, the workers of light in the creation here. They are riding in his chariot. So these are the new gods he is bringing along with him. They are the new gods. They are not the old gods riding in his chariot, you see. Broad base to bear the gods on fiery wheels. So his wheels are really, bring me my bow of burning gold, bring me my chariot of fire. That is how William Blake says in his poem, bring me my bow of burning gold, bring me a chariot of fire, my chariot of fire, fiery wheels. Flaming, he swept through the spiritual gate. Now he was in the transcendent, he is coming down into the spiritual domains. Down below, spiritual domain starts from the overmind, down below, the highest station of mind. From that down, he is coming here. Because he has to work here now. He has to carry out the business of created things. So he is coming back now for that. The mortal star received him in its midst. The mortal star received him in its midst. He is back now to the earth. Has come back to the ashram in our analogy, you see. And he has to now write letters to all the sadhaka, all the disciples. My problem is this, my problem is that. And he has to keep on writing for 8 hours every day in the night, every night for 8 years like that, you see. He has to keep on doing that job now, you see. The martyrs received him in his midst. Once more he moved amid material scene. That is the important thing. Once more, in fact, he has gone from here, from the material scene, to the transcendent plane. He is back now here again. Once more he moved amid material scene, lifted by intimation from the high. Yes, he is back here in the mortal world, but every time the intimation from the high, the inspiration, the revelation keep on coming to him. Constantly, and twixt the pauses to the building brain, touched by the thought that skimmed the fathomless soul of nature and being back to hidden shore. Those revelations come, they skim on the waters of nature and go back. He is receiving them. He is here now. They are not permanent. Now, we shall see this thing in more detail. And twixt the pauses of the building brain. This is a very, very important line. And all the quarrel starts with this line. You see. He said, fix the pauses. There is the you should take the cardiograph, it goes up, then again goes up, again goes up here. So between this activity and this activity, there is a kind of a pause. It is between these pauses, in other words, when it is picking up. During that period of peaking, something is happening. And twixt the pause, I'll tell you in a minute. Twixt the pauses of the building brain, touched by the thoughts, has skimmed the fathomless soul of nature and being back to hidden shores. The eternal seeker in the aeonic field. See, this man, this yogi, whatever you want to call him, has attained whatever he wanted to attain. He has approached the Divine Mother herself. She has given him what he wanted, and yet he is a seeker. yet he is a seeker, eternal seeker. What else you want? You have seen the Divine Mother, you have approached her, you have received whatever she wants to give you, and yet he is a seeker. Eternal seeker in the aeonic field, in the field of time. Aeonic field, in the field of yugas, in the field of cycles of time, he is a seeker still. Yes, I approached her. But now the context is the context of the aeonic field of the cycles of time. It is in the cycles of time he is the seeker who is the eternal seeker. He does not want anything from it. Now it is, whatever has to happen now has to happen in the aeonic field, besieged with the intolerant press of power, again for strong, for great, split-footed days. Yes, he is active now, he is dynamic with all that force, with all that thing what he had received from her in the field here. The eternal seeker, the aeonic being, awake beneath the ignorant vault of night. See, that night is there, he is awake there. He saw the unnumbered people of the stars and heard the questioning of the unsatisfied flood and toy with the storm, with the form maker. Measuring mind. Awake beneath the ignorant vault of night. Who is there? The form maker. Who is the form maker? Mind. The attribute, the quality, the property of mind to measure out things. To measure out things. To give form, to shape. So he is now back here in the mental world, Manomaya. Awake when the ignorant vault of night. See, the night is there, the voice, etc. But he is always awake. That is not good. He saw the unnumbered people of the stars. So this is what he is going to see here. And heard the questioning of the unsatisfied flood. What these people want, they are asking for something, demanding something of him. Yes. And toil with the form maker, measuring mind. A wanderer from the occult, invisible sun, accomplishing the fate of transient things, accomplishing the fate of transient things. He has done that thing. Wanderer from the occult, invisible sun, again sun, plural, you see. A god in the figure of the Eurasian beast, god in the figure of the beast itself. He is rising up now, what is doing. He raised his brow of conquest to the heaven, establishing the empire of the soul on matter and its bounded universe as a solid rock in infinite sea. This is what he has done now here. And then the Lord of Life resumed his mighty round, He has come back to the mortal world. He has to carry on the business of created things. Mighty rounds of this world. He has to attend to the official files of the king. Or the papers which go to him for signature, for decisions and all that. He has to attend to all those things. The Lord of Life resumed his mighty round in the scanned field of the ambiguous globe. That is our ambiguous globe, you see. In the scanned field, Lord of Life. See, this of course refers to Ashwapati, who has come back now with the divine gift, Lord of Life. Life is described in the Veda as Prana, Shakti. Horses, they are the carriers of Prana Shakti. He is the master of those Prana Shakti, of life forces, life forces. It is when he has received the boon from the Divine Mother, he really becomes the Lord of Life. When he received the boon from the Divine Mother, he becomes the Lord of Life. So in this canto we have, first she had addressed him as, O Son of Strength. Then she said, O strong forerunner. And then we had, But Ashwapati answered to her, Ashwapati. That was the first time his name is spelled out in the epic, Ashwapati. Now he is the lord of life, the master of life. Now this mastery of life means the contingencies of the transient world cannot curtail him, cannot affect him at all. His actions will not be constrained in any way by the forces of this world. He is above them all. It is because of that he can attain to the business of created things. He has to attain to the business of created things, vast business of created things. With that force now in him, he is attending to the daily work. That is the siddhi. When you approach Divine Mother and receive the force for what? For action here. It is not to go and merge into the divine and disappear from this creation. It is for action here in this world. Business of created things cannot be forgotten at all, you see. So he has to carry on the kingly duties, has to attend to the office and do all those things, created things, as a part of his work, you see. But okay, let us first see in that context now this line. And twixt the pauses of the building brain. The brain is active, brain is silent, brain is active, brain is silent. Now it is not during when the brain is silent that things are happening. But when the brain is active, things are happening. That is the business of created things. That is the business of created things, you see. It is not in silence, in trance, in meditation, in withdrawal that you seek the divine benedictions and divine boons and divine peace. It is in the dynamics of life that you have to realize all those possibilities. When things are active, dynamic, then only you have to, the divine expression should be in the dynamism of life, not in the quiescence of life, but in the dynamism of life, the divine activity. Therefore, it is when the brain is active that things are happening in Ashwapati. The created things, spiritual gates are open and these things have to happen there. Business of created things. Now, twixt, Sri Aurobindo has written this passage 8 or 10 times. These lines, 8 or 10 times. One by one, he kept on revising and doing and doing and doing all that. Now, in the drafts which were earlier than where twixt appears in the last draft. In all the earlier drafts, he had, and in the pauses of the building brain. Exactly. In the earlier drafts, instead of twixt, we had in. And in the process of the building brain. That is perfectly understandable. Because Sri Aurobindo says, all your activities should be in the quiet. Now, by simply changing one word, the whole psychology, the whole approach, the whole methodology of operation is completely altered. No, when you are active, then you should be able to receive the divine power and divine shakti and divine presence. Not in quiescence. What is the use of that? So one single change like that has radicalized the whole expression. You see. In 1942, he changed from in to twixt and in the pauses of the building brain has become and twixt the pauses of the building brain. It's a very, very remarkable change, you see. Absolutely remarkable change. Now people, well, the unfortunate thing is, very, very unfortunate thing is, in the revised edition of Savitri, they have put in the last 1993 edition of Savitri, revised edition of Savitri, they have gone back to the earlier draft in, and big, big, big arguments were there in between all that. They say that how it is contradictory to Sri Aurobindo's philosophy. In the silent mind, you receive whatever has to be received. and therefore Sri Aurobindo has become mystic. It is a slip on the part of Sri Aurobindo. This is exactly what Amarnathiran has said, written in an article. When I was fighting about this one, no, Twixt has a greater meaning, greater stuff, greater content. Please retain Twixt. He argued, he wrote a long article in Mother India, 1987. And he said, this is contradictory. Twixt is contradictory to entire spiritual philosophy of Sri Aurobindo. But then when I am arguing that he is attending to the created things in the possibility of the divine action in the activity of life here, there is no question of in and all that. It has to be fully dynamic. And we quarrel, we fought and all that thing, but then ultimately I had to withdraw. I made a note, I wrote the article, all that thing. And in reply to that article, he wrote another long article in Mother India. Justifying, he says, this is one of the rarest examples of a slip on the part of Sri Aurobindo.
He knows
that. So when we discuss this issue and all that thing, well, then I'm a small man, so he's a big person who has come directly from Sri Aurobindo. It'll be tricks there. It'll be tricks there. Because this is prior to 1993. This is prior to 1993. So that is the big history behind that. Created things, all that thing is completely forgotten. I said, look, he is now, his consciousness is an incontingent consciousness. It does not depend upon circumstances. That you do like this, you do like this under the circumstance. No, the divine power, the divine activity is constantly there, irrespective of what you are doing, in what you are engaged with. That cannot be at all. That is a much greater spiritual attainment than in quiescence. All right, as an apprentice yogi, as a beginner, you had to go by the silent mind in the pauses of the building brain. In the beginning, early stages, but now when you are the master, when you are the lord of life, with the question of anything now, there is no condition at all which can stop you, halt you at all. You had to be fully there. It is always there, you see. So I insisted, I said, no. Well, then I had to depart and then all those things happened, you see. So this is a very famous battle. And Twixt deposits the building brain. But now, people also forget one more thing. The whole argument here is that on the part of Amarnathiran and others, that Sri Aurobindo Yoga is first in the silent mind. So it has to happen, whatever has to happen in silent. But silent mind is permanently there. It is not going to get disturbed by any activity or non-activity. It is always there, you see.